DeltaJSON provides you with a JSON delta file, and it's worth explaining what this is and how it can be used. The delta file includes all of the data from both the input files and represents the differences between them. Therefore, if you compare file A with file B, the delta shows any items that are in A only or in B only, or where the value differs between A and B. Where an item is the same in both files, then no changes are shown. As an aside, the delta has been designed so that it can represent changes between more than two files, but we'll not go into the details of that here. The contextual delta is very useful. You can produce from it any combination of the two input files you may need. For example, a union or a two-way merge. That union could choose either the A or the B, where there are differences, or you can even make different choices according to the context. You could even use it to generate a SQL update script to update a database to reflect the changes between A and B. You may know that there is a standard JSON patch format for showing changes between two JSON files, and we can generate that, but we don't recommend its use for processing changes. And the reason why we don't use JSON patch is that it suffers from a number of significant limitations. For example, it depends on the order of the JSON items within arrays, and if these are changed, the patch will no longer work. JSON patch is designed only to patch one file to produce another, and it can't be used to patch any variant of the original file, and this makes its utility somewhat limited. The Delta format that we've designed doesn't suffer from those limitations. The contextual information contained in the Delta file enables us to implement a much more powerful version of patch, which is able to patch variants. And we call this a smart patch, and it works very much like the graft operation. So do take a look at the JSON delta, and you'll probably find other ways that you can use it.